Before we proceed to learning Java, we need to talk about how to write and run it. This video is about different ways to write and deploy Java applications, along with their benefits and drawbacks. Believe it or not, it is entirely possible to write a functioning Java application using only a plain text editor like Notepad and a Java development kit, often abbreviated as JDK. You can probably guess what the text editor is for, but the JDK gives us two very important tools. The Java compiler program Java C, which as discussed in the previous episode, will create our Java bytecode. Also, a Java runtime environment, or JRE, which among other things contains a Java virtual machine, which interacts with the operating system. So, do I recommend you use this approach? Almost definitely not. It is impractical for most graphical user interface programs and does not provide design time, i.e. before compile time, help with syntax and error highlighting. However, it is worth learning to use this approach as a good learning exercise, especially if you plan to work with Linux. An integrated development environment, or IDE, is a needlessly complex name for a program which you use to write other programs. As you have probably noticed already, us programmers have insecurities just like everybody else, and one of the ways they choose to vent that insecurity is by giving things scary, complex, and obscure names to make themselves feel smart. Let us talk about why almost every Java developer I know uses an IDE. They have a built-in text editor with design time error and syntax highlighting, as well as code completion. They usually have a built-in compiler and sometimes a built-in Java runtime environment. Creating, building, and managing projects is very easy. If for some reason you cannot set up or run an IDE on your computer and you do not want to torture yourself with Notepad and the command line, the next best option is to find an online Java IDE. If you search either online Java compiler or online Java editor in your preferred search engine, you will find a bunch of different websites which effectively provide you with a browser-based IDE. I will not recommend one in particular, but look for one with syntax highlighting and error checking. Being able to create multiple files would also be a big bonus. Just be cautious of malware and try to find one with a good reputation. There should be some free tools like that out there. If you are really serious about getting into Java desktop, web, or Android development, you will probably want to download a real IDE. Personally, I like to use IntelliJ IDEA, Android Studio, and Eclipse for Java development. I will be using IntelliJ IDEA with the dark theme enabled during coding lessons, in case you're curious. Also, if you plan to get into Android development, definitely go with IDEA or Android Studio, because Android Studio is based on IDEA. I know a few people who like to use NetBeans, but it would not be my first choice, or second choice for that matter. You will likely also want to download and install either a JRE or a JDK. If you're using an IDE, a JRE is probably sufficient, but I would recommend grabbing the JDK anyways. Just as a reminder, the Java Development Kit is made for developers, whereas the JRE is basically just a way for anyone to deploy Java applications on their computer. A JDK will contain a JRE. The Oracle website is a secure place where you can download these things. A word of warning, setting up an IDE on an operating system is not always easy. Every programmer must deal with the issue of configuring environments, and even the best of us sometimes have to spend hours and even days solving these problems.